Hi, very good evening students. Welcome to video classes. I hope you all are fine. All of you stay home, stay safe, learn well. Okay. So, students, we are learning characteristics of animals. Okay, so in that growth and response to stimuli. Okay. So, that we know, right? Some characteristics of animals, that is, they breathe, they move from one place to another place, they are heterotrophs, they cannot prepare their own food, they depend directly or indirectly on plants for their food, and they reproduce to increase their number, they excrete, and they have sensitivity, right? These are all characteristics of animals, right? Okay, so here, next we are going to know about growth and response to stimuli. So, all plants and animals are living things. They need basic necessities like air, food, and water to live and grow, right? So, these are the conditions under which living beings select their habitat, right? Okay. Why they are going to select their habitat? To grow, right? Like plants, animals do have varied growth patterns. Okay, so they also show responses to certain stimuli. When someone flashed bright light in front of your eyes, you are going to react to the light by shutting your eyes, right? Okay, so like that, something which causes a response is called a stimuli or a stimulus. So here we are going to know about how animals grow and give response to stimuli. Okay, so like plants, animals to have varied growth patterns. They also show responses to certain stimuli. So then, what is growth? Growth is nothing but a male child grows into a boy, right? Okay, all of you see here in this picture, this is male child, right? Okay, after some days, a male child grows into a boy, right? Okay, so the boy later grows into a man, right? Okay, so likewise, kitten. Okay, all of you see here, kittens, cats, okay, small cats. This kittens grows into a cat. Okay, so here a caterpillar grows into a butterfly, okay, and tadpole grows into a frog. Okay, so this is all growth, right? Growth is nothing but the increase in size and their number, right? Okay, so here all human beings, caterpillars, tadpole, they increases their size, right? So that is nothing but growth. Students, do the young ones of all animals look similar? No, right? Certainly not. They vary in size, looks, and they vary in their abilities also, right? Okay, so for example, all of you see here, a newborn calf. Okay, so this is newborn calf, can stand on its own, right? Okay, so but here A newborn human baby cannot stand, right? So, as the young ones grow, their body parts grow, right? Okay, so as the young ones grow, their body parts grow too, right? As like here in this picture, right? Okay, as a baby girl starts growing up like this, her hands and legs grow, right? Hands, legs grow, right? Okay, and she become taller also, right? Okay, so but after a period of time, when the adulthood had reached, the body parts stop growing. Okay, so thus in animals, physical growth is not continuous. Okay, so instead it stops after a some period of time. Okay, as the young ones of animals grow, they develop different body features like hair, fur, teeth or wings, right? Okay, so here two puppies or two chicks. Okay, so here all of you see here puppies may have similar body parts. Okay, so yet their looks is different. Okay, they look differ, right? Okay, also one animal may grow up faster or may be healthier as compared to other animal of the same kind, right?